Welcome to this video on editing pages in SharePoint 2013. Here, we'll cover how to change a page's title or layout, how to add content to a page, how to check drafts, and how to delete a page. This video assumes you are familiar with the process to create a page. If you aren't, we suggest you view the video on Create and Publish a Page first. Let's see how to change the title of a page on Inside NCDOT. Click the Page tab and Edit. The page opens for editing and is automatically checked out to you. At the top of the page is the title text box, which contains the current page title. Let's make the title plural. Note that the change does not affect the page address or URL. Click Check It In to save and check in the page. Describe any changes you've made and click Continue. Then click Publish This Draft. Once published, page changes are visible immediately, with the exception of those pages on Connect NCDOT that are visible to the general public. Those pages go live at 42 past each hour to give you ample time for proofing. On Connect NCDOT, you can choose between two different page layouts. If you opt for one layout, then change your mind, here's how to swap layouts. Let's go to the FAQ page on the SharePoint Help site on Connect NCDOT. Click the Page tab and click Edit. The page is checked out to you and is open for editing. The current layout has a wide left column, narrow right column, and a full-width footer. When you click Page Layout, you'll see the current layout highlighted with a yellow frame. The other layout for Connect NCDOT is wide top and wide bottom. So click the alternate layout for your page. Because we're going from two columns to one, SharePoint has to rearrange web parts on the page. If you are satisfied with the new layout, save, check in, and publish the page so the change is visible to others. I simply wanted to demo how to swap the layout, but I don't want to save the change. So I'll use the discard checkout option and confirm with an OK to cancel my work. Inside NCDOT uses only one page layout, so it's never necessary to change page layouts there. Let's go back to Inside NCDOT and look at how to add content to a page. For example, here's an announcements list with a view of the five most recent announcements, a calendar, and a document library with a view of the three newest documents. But you'll often want to combine different types of content on one page. On a page on a task force team site, for example, you might want a calendar as well as current announcements and new documents, and you might want an image to liven it up a bit. We just looked at two lists and a library we'll use in this example. Let's go to the Images library and find an image to use. Copy its URL by hovering over the image, clicking the ellipsis, and using Ctrl-C. Finally, here's the empty page called Task Force. So, we have all the components we need: announcements, calendar, library, image, and page. Let's assemble them. Click the Page tab and Edit. First, add the calendar. In the top left Web Part zone, click Add a Web Part. Make sure you're in the Apps category, then click the right arrow in the Parts section to scroll to the team calendar. Click it, then click Add. And here's our calendar. Now add the announcements. In the top right Web Part zone, click Add a Web Part. We're still in the Apps category, so scroll back and click the Announcements app, then Add. Take a look at the announcements. The All Items view is shown by default, but we only want to see the most recent announcements. Hover over the title, click the down arrow, and click Edit Web Part. Under Selected View, choose Most Recent 5. Click OK to confirm, then OK to stop editing the web part. Now we see only the last 5 announcements. Next, add the image. In the top left Web Part zone, click Add a Web Part. Click the Media and Content category, the Image Viewer Web Part, and Add. We need to tell SharePoint what image to use, so click Open the Tool Pane and OK to continue. In the Edit menu, paste the URL to the image in the Image Link box. Click Test Link to open the image in a separate tab. Return to the page and click OK to save changes. And here's our image. Finally, add the new documents. In the top right web part zone, click Add a web part. Click Apps as the category, scroll to and click the Shared Documents app, then click Add. The All Documents view is shown by default. Let's edit the web part so it shows only the new documents. Hover over the title, click the down arrow, and click Edit Web Part. Under Selected View, choose New Documents and click OK to confirm. Then click OK to save your changes. Check in the page, describe your changes, and click Continue. And here's our example of combining different types of content on one page. This is a very quick example of editing a page. To give the page a cleaner look, you might choose to rearrange the web parts, to hide the toolbars, and to change or hide the web part titles. You can find more details on how to make these changes in our videos on the List View and Image Viewer web parts. Let's click the Page tab to look at three important edit options you will find useful while working on SharePoint pages. The Save and Keep Editing option lets you save the changes you've made so that others can see them, but keep the page checked out so you can continue to work. This is useful if you are making extensive edits but want to let others see your new changes periodically. The Stop Editing option discontinues your editing and discards your changes. If versioning is turned on, this creates a new version, so it is generally better to use Discard Checkout to exit cleanly. Use Discard Checkout if you have made no changes or don't want to keep the changes you've made. This option does not create new versions. You can use the Draft Check feature to identify unpublished content or links to unpublished content on a page. If some page content hasn't been published, you may well see gaps on the page and content that doesn't appear. Go to the FAQ page on the SharePoint Help site on Connect NCDOT. Click the Page tab and Draft Check. Wait while the check occurs. Draft Check has detected an issue. Click Full Report to see the report in a pop-up window. The yellow outline on the page corresponds to the yellow Old Version warning in the report. Click Old Version for an explanation of the issue. The message indicates that the new user page has been updated but not published. Click the URL and you'll see that the new user page has indeed been changed but not published. Now, let's run a draft check on the homepage of the Designer Work Zone on Inside NCDOT. Click the Page tab and Draft Check. Wait while the check occurs. Click Full Report for details of the problem. Click Not Approved for an explanation. Here, an item has never been published or approved, so if the current page is published, the link to that item will be broken. Click the URL to see what has not been finalized. In this particular example, it's some code done by our developers that won't affect page display or content. The simplest way to delete a page is go to the page, click the Settings gear, Edit Page, and OK to check it out. Click Delete Page and OK to confirm the deletion. There's another way to delete a page if you're in the Pages library. Click the ellipsis next to the name of the page, then the ellipsis in the callout. Click Delete, then OK to confirm the deletion. Deleted pages are moved to the recycle bin, but can be restored if needed. In this video, we've reviewed how to edit a page title, change page layout, add content to a page, check for unpublished content, and delete a page. We encourage you to check out our other SharePoint videos, as well as the reference and training materials on the SharePoint Help site. On Connect NCDOT, there is a link to help on every page. Go to the main Help page and click SharePoint Help to see the SharePoint Help information. On Inside NCDOT, There is a link to the help site in the header and footer of every page. Those links also take you to the SharePoint help site. For information on upcoming SharePoint classes, log into Beacon and check the LMS training calendar, or contact the PC training group. Thanks for watching.